Welcome to part 2 on how to construct a circle graph or pie chart. The goal of this video is to construct a circle graph or pie chart from data. So just to review, it's important to remember that a circle represents 360 degrees or one complete rotation. Meaning if we started with an initial ray, as we see here, and rotated all the way around the circle, back to where we started, that would be 360 degrees. And then secondly, it's important that we know how to measure an angle using a protractor as we see here. Because what we're going to do is divide up this circle into sectors to represent each category based on what percent of 360 degrees that category would represent. Here's how we're going to do that. From the raw data, we'll determine what percent of the total data is from each category. Then we'll determine what percent of 360 degrees represents each category. And then we'll divide up the circle based upon the measurement in degrees. Let's go ahead and look at an example. Let's say a certain number of people are surveyed to ask which type of car they prefer. And these are the results of that survey. So 10 people liked Chevys, 5 preferred Dodge, 20 preferred Ford, and so on. The first thing we need to do is determine how many people were surveyed. So if we find the sum of this column, we'll have the total number of people that were surveyed. If we do that, we're going to get 80. So 10 out of 80 prefer Chevys. So what we need to do is find 10 80ths of 360 degrees. Now we could simplify the fraction, but we're going to go ahead and use the calculator for these calculations anyway. So we want 10 80ths of 360 degrees. So we're going to multiply this by 360 degrees. The next category is 5 80ths. So we want 5 80ths of 360 degrees. Next would be 20 80ths over 360 degrees. 15 80ths of 360 degrees. And the last category is 30 80ths of 360 degrees. Again, we could simplify these fractions, but there's really no need if we're going to use the calculator. So now these products will tell us how many degrees of the circle each category should represent. So this first category would be 45 degrees. Well, 5 80ths is half as many as the first category, so that would be half of 45, that's 22.5 degrees. Notice the next category is twice the first category. Well, 2 times 45 degrees would be 90 degrees. And then 15 out of 80 would be the same as combining these two categories. So if we add these two angles, that would represent 15 80ths of 360 degrees. That's 67.5 degrees. And let's go ahead and use our calculator for this last one. If we press second enter, I can just change the first fraction. So I'll change this to 30 80ths. Be 135 degrees. And of course, I could have done the same for these other ones. If I press second enter and change the 30 to 15, I could check the previous category. And we see that it checks. So this last category is 135 degrees. Now notice my protractor is a complete circle. You probably just have half of a circle, or 180 degrees. So what you probably would do is mark off each angle and then rotate your protractor. But unfortunately, I can't do that here. So what I'm going to do is just mark off 45 degrees. So I'll start here. 45 degrees would be right here. So the first category would be in this sector. So I'll put a C for Chevy. The next category is 22.5 degrees. That's going to be approximately half of this sector here. So maybe somewhere in here. This is for the Dodge. The next category is 90 degrees. So I'm going to go ahead and just mark it down here. Because I know that's 1/4 of a circle. So this would be for the Fords. The last two categories are 135 degrees and 67.5 degrees. I'm going to go ahead and mark off 135 degrees. I know from here to here would be 180. And 180 minus 45 would be 135. So this sector here would be 135 degrees. This is for the Toyotas. And that leaves this last category here, which is 67.5 degrees for the Hyundai. And let's go ahead and add a little bit of color. And there we go. So really the most important thing here is to be able to find a certain percent of 360 degrees and then to be able to measure it around a circle. That way each category is the correct size based upon the percent of data from that category. I hope you found this explanation helpful.